Hello everyone, today I make a fast fun food ramen noodles wrap hot dog and very crispy. You give it to your children, you give it to anyone, they will love it. No matter how old are they feel like a children again. Welcome to Saigon Cook Travel. I am Saigon Cook. First, let's get started with the ingredients. I have hot dogs case here, but I will use 4 of them. And I will use 2 eggs. My eggs are small. If your egg is big, you can use 1. A cup of milk, cornstarch, on-purpose flour, and tempura butter mix. If you don't have it, you can use the other kind, like this one. It's called a crispy fry mix. And I have a bone and a cup here. The bone, I will mix the butter in it, and after that, I will transfer to the cup because the hot dog is long. It need to have something deep, so that we can dip it in. For hot dogs, I use extra measurement here. You can use leftover for just use this for the hot dog. And then you don't need the noodles for the next day. So I use a half cup of on-purpose flour, a quarter cup of cornstarch, and a quarter cup of tempura butter. And the seasoning here, 1 teaspoon of sugar, half a teaspoon of salt, and a quarter teaspoon of ground black pepper, and I have half a teaspoon of mustard. Later on, when I break the ramen noodle bag, there is a seasoning bag inside, and I will use some of that too. Now I mix the flour with on this seasoning. And I make a well in the center to break the eggs in. And I will try to break the eggs, to stir the eggs, to mix the eggs first so that the eggs are mixed thoroughly before I add the milk. You can see I try to make in the center so that my flour doesn't go all over the place. And when I'm doing that, I add milk at a time so that I don't get any lump in my batters. So finally, I have a good mix here. I'm just stir one more time around, and that's it. I will transfer to the cup now. You can see our hot dog is long, so you need something deep to dip them in. You remember, if a state fair, if you go there or if you watch the fair on TV, you will see people do a corn dog, and they have a big bone of butter, and they dip the hot dog in it. So this one is a very similar to corn dog, but with the corn dog you need to have corn meal You don't wrap it in anything. But this one, you need to make batter, and outside the outer layer will be ramen noodles. And when you do so, the ramen noodles, when it's fried, very crunchy, and it's very interesting to eat. Now I'm cutting a square on end of my hot dog. The reason I do that, when I fry my hot dog, that cut will spread out, spread outward, and it makes just like flour, and it's fun and beautiful that way. Now I use the stick to skew my hot dog. Remember, the stick size will need to be accommodated in your frying pan later. So if too long, you cannot fry properly. So keep it in mind. So my, I think, is a little long. After I'm done with skewing, I will cut it down. This stick is not a special stick. I just use the chopstick from takeout or Chinese restaurant. They always have those chopsticks. And I love them because you can use it to make your skewers. So that's it for preparing the hot dogs. So I set aside there, and now we go to the next step, that we prepare the ramen. You can use shrimp ramen, or you can use beef or chicken or whatever flavor that you have on hand. I have a shrimp ramen here, so I use this. So I use the rolling pin to break the bag so that the noodle inside will be smaller size. And I need them to be uniform so that later when I dip outside the hot dogs, they will be uniform. They don't look one long and one short. You will see when I will get there. So now I will cut the bag open, and you can see the size of the ramen right now. It's already small, and that's what you want, because they resemble the breadcrumbs. You can see right there. That makes me happy about that. Now, like I said before, I use some of the seasoning in the seasoning bag. I don't use the whole thing because you remember earlier we used salt, pepper, sugar, mustard. So they already season a little. So I just need to add more than half of the seasoning back in here. And I stir around so that they mix too. And I think that's it. And we're ready to dip our hot dog. So I will be doing that. And I like to take opportunity to say thank you for stopping by to watch my video. If you're new to my channel, please subscribe. It means a lot to me. You are the reason I'm here. I like to share everything I know with you. I have a passion for food. I learned to do many things, and I got a lot of experience over the years. and I want to share everything I know with you. You can realize that I dip not to the end of the my hot dog, because you remember when I make a square in the and in there, I want them to expose. So that when I fry, those hot dog end will spread out like a flowers. If you cover them, they won't be visible anymore, and it's a waste of your purpose. So I am deep in the butter, and then the noodles, and I keep doing this so that the noodles stick to the hot dog very well. You want them to stick very well, otherwise when you fry, the ramen noodle will fall into the pan, and it will burn and your oil will be color and cloudy, and it's not healthy that way. You need to make sure your ramen stick to the hot dog. I mean that stick to the batter, and the batter stick to the hot dog. So I run around to make sure they are uniform in size, and I saw some of the batter try to fall out. So at this point, you know what I was gonna do? I will use my hand to press the noodle and the batter into the hot dog so that they are kept there. They don't fall. I don't like them to fall in my oil, like I explained to you before. When the ramen fall out, you will have the expo hot dog not covered completely, and that make not beautiful product. And more than that, your oil will be cloudy and burn. So you can see I use my hands now to make sure the ramen stay on the hot dog. And I feel that I'm pretty safe now, and we will be ready for the fry. Because this one, this hot dog is long. Normally I use a small and tall pair pot so that I can fry things, so that I use less oil. If you watch my video of fried milk, you will see how I handle the oil. But for this recipe, I don't have the pot that tall, and if I do, I need a lot of oil, so I use the pan instead. And you can see, you need the oil just cover the top of the hot dog. That's it. When you see my first one there, that after I fry 1 minute, I've tried to flip, and it's not nearly brown like I like. So I better leave each side 3 minutes so that they are golden brown. You can see now, after 3 minutes, I flip, and it looks beautiful, and it will be done that way. And you also see the end of my hot dog. They spread out beautifully, just like flower. So like I said, 3 minutes each side, and then I remove out to line the paper towel line place, so that all the oil don't stay in the hot dog. So I think that I raise the oil temperature up, and I will drop the sticks in again. This time I fry only 1 minute. I try to crisp them even more. But I think with 3 minutes each side, you don't need to do one more minute like I do. If you do, it's crispier, but if you don't, they already crispy enough. So I try to get the oil out of my hot dog sticks and remove them from oil back on the line, paper towel line place, and that's it. We are ready for presentation. You can see in almost every American household, you can find hot dog all the time. And in every Asian household, you can find ramen noodle in the pantry. So each one have very cheap and easy item in the house. So why not combine the two and you have fabulous snack. Let's eat. Thank you for watching. I hope I inspire you to make this for yourself and your family. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye-bye.